how this tool has made me a better editor, and why I believe this can also make you a better and much more efficient editor. How? Easy. We're talking about the trim edit mode in Resolve, and if you don't know what that is, or you don't know how this can make you a better editor, you should be watching very carefully. Now, first up, the trim edit mode is in the toolbar right above your timeline, in between the selection mode, which is what I think most users are in 90% of their time editing, and the cut mode, which I honestly never use because to chop my clips, I use my keyboard shortcuts Q, W, and E. But what's so different about this tool and how can it actually make you a much more efficient editor? Reason number one has to be precision. The trim edit mode allows you to make precise cuts and edits to your footage. With this mode, you can adjust the in and out points of your clips with frame level accuracy, giving you more control over the final product. But you can do the same thing within the select mode as well, so what's the deal? Now this is true, but if we take a look at the select mode, we can see that if we decrease this clip in length, it leaves an unwanted gap behind. And furthermore, if we want to extend this clip in length, it now starts to override the next clip. But if we use the trim edit mode instead, and we decrease the same clip in length, we can see that the rest of the timeline also gets shifted in, leaving no unwanted gaps behind. And furthermore, if we extend that same clip, it does not override the next clip. Instead, it also shifts everything that is to the right of this cut also to the right. Now you can see that using the trim edit mode more often can benefit your overall workflow speed because you eliminate all the unnecessary and time-consuming steps in between while still making precise edits to your footage. But that's still only the beginning. If you have your edit already done, but later on you decide to change a clip to a different part of the shot without changing the entire timeline in length, you typically have to drag the clip to the next video layer, extend the start and end points, and then shift around to see what part might fit your story or montage better. And once decided, you again have to trim in the start and end points and bring the clip back to its original place. No, these are way too many steps that overall just take way too long. Now simply switch over to the trim edit mode and hover your cursor over the clip that you want to change. You notice a cursor change when you hover over the thumbnail area of your shot, but also at the bottom blue or whatever color it is for you outline. But let's focus on the thumbnail area first. If you click and hold the thumbnail area, you can now see a white box appears around your clip. And that box is actually the original length of your clip. So you can see that we have some space over on the left side and some space over on the right side. And now you can drag your mouse right or left to quickly change the start and end points of your clip without changing the actual clip in length. Again, you just eliminated 2 to 3 unnecessary and time-consuming steps to do the same task. If you now take a look at the viewer, you can see that while clicking and holding the thumbnail area, you notice that the viewer changes from 1 image to 4. Now at first sight, this might look very complicated, but I promise it's actually super easy and useful. The images in the top are the in and out points of that specific shot that you're currently working on. And the image in the bottom left is the last frame from the previous clip, while the image in the bottom right side is the first frame of the next clip. Just a quick side note here. If you change the in and out points by moving your mouse left or right while you hold the thumbnail area, these images at the bottom will have updates, so you can easily see the first and last frame and also how good they match up to the previous and the next clip. But that's still not everything the trim mode allows you to do. If you now click and hold the bottom blue line, you can actually see the same white outline appearing once again. If we now drag this clip to the left, we can actually see that we override the previous clip while at the same time extending the next shot. And if we now drag this clip to the right, we can actually see that we're extending the prior clip, but we're also overriding the next clip. Again, not leaving any unwanted gaps behind. And if we take a look at the viewer now, you can see that we have the same 4 images set up as we had previously. So I guess you can tell that using the trim edit mode more often can actually benefit your overall workflow speed by eliminating unnecessary and time-consuming tasks. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you learned something new. If so, please let me know in the comments down below. Also, make sure to leave a like and a subscribe if you haven't already. And I'm gonna see you next week's video. Bye.